Hey guys, alright, so we're going to be doing a little bit of a micro refinement day for muzaka guild boss. I'm probably too lazy to do this, but I think I might just use Lee for my second slot. Just so I can save on crystals for ungearing, but I forget what he's wearing. So, what's the formation for this? I'm pretty sure it's 0 number 1. You want a weak zero. This is important that you have a weak zero so he can die. His only role is to take the sigil. If you could make a really overpowered zero, then you could have him in like slot 3 or something like that, and you could have Alfred slot 1, and you could replace in the formation, you could replace Dominique or something like that with zero as the main DPS in the middle, and you could have, let's say, Alfred on slot 1, and he'll go take the sigil. But you also need somebody in the sigil for the other side so that Lilith will go and grab that one. Now, before Lilith goes and grabs and pulls whoever, you're going to want to get your overkill. So this is where I might go with Lee, but we'll just put Dominique in because she's definitely the best. My Dominique is crappy just because. And then you want two area heroes, so I'm going to go with Yekaterina. And then muzaka, so I'm not going to do that at all because I wasn't thinking clearly, of course. Greatest guide ever. Then you want Lilith, and then you're going to want muzaka in slot 5. Ideally, actually, muzaka goes in slot 6, so the people using the mercenaries might be able to get better scores just because. And I could probably drop Alfred for Yekaterina. I might do that. If you are worried about having your team survive, there's some really easy things you could do to make sure. So let's just go over some of them. First, you don't want to have your defense too high on these characters. It's fine to have strong stuff, whatever. And I want some overkill, so I might just go BR Adasso. But you know what? I got this chest piece the other day. This could be one of my pieces, so I don't go too crazy over. And we'll take a weapon, and I'll take that ring. And what's Lee wearing? Okay. The only thing I would want to take is probably the Persona's trick, so I think I'll just leave it like that. And I'll just pick something else. Oh, and the Dasso piece is definitely coming off. Who needs you anymore? Do I use Seer tomorrow? Don't think anymore. Gotta be thinking about that kind of stuff. Okay. Alright, so let's go up to Dominique. Start decking the crap out of her. Just use this as my strongest necklace for this star level. Okay, you got nothing on, right? Alright, sweet. That's just how Angela likes her Dominiques. Okay, probably should go ring for slot 2, so I should take a chest piece slot 3, but I don't know if I have any good rings lying around. That looks nice. The only ring I have is the EC piece, and I need it. Oh, there we go. Crit rate, crit damage, attack by HP. That's fine. Oh, I had this one over here the whole time. That I'm willing to waste 8 one time to see if I get boss damage on it. But it's for the overkill, so it's really not super important. Oh, damage to minion, whatever. Wasted my one. 3.1, 7.5, 1.2. I'm taking this one. Alright. Crit rate all the way down. That's what you want to see. I guess I'll take this instead, just because it's easier than equipping Lee right now. This gives more attack anyway, so that's fine. Over here, we could go with the Pathfinder instead, the attack piece, because it gives more. And maybe I'll take this one with a higher crit rate. That should help max out my crit to 100, but I should probably do my Omni set before I do anything. Attack, attack, HP, defense. No, I don't want that. I want the one on Lee. That's better. Alright, I will actually be getting to the muzaka stuff. But it is important to see kind of how you could optimally gear your team up. Alright, perfect mastery. Alright, yeah. So I want 100% crit rate, so I'll go with the Pathfinder. Alright, 100,000 health, 100% crit rate, low defense. Alright, so this is ideal. What's my attack? 36,000, that's terrible. My skills aren't even maxed. Gotta work on this too. But still, even at level 8, that's still way stronger than anybody else. Okay, alright, so we got Dominique. Let's see if Katrina's sitting at. I'll get her two Dasso pieces. Probably just ones with good potentials too. Like that. Oh, damage to boss. Done. This is only slightly worth it because it's only going to work for one turn because she's going to be taking the sigil. Alright, so one. What do you got? 38,000. Alright, and defense. Alright, so yeah, that's low enough. Decent-ish crit rate. Less you can do with a bunch of maces. Maybe I can get rid of this for some... for a sweet bow. Come on, sweet bow. Are you lying around somewhere? If only this was 3-star. Guys could always just do that. Whatever. I'll have to make a new bow later. Alright, 78%. If I do put that on, I can put a ring on. No, that's too sweet. I'll get rid of that. What do I have here? That's pretty sweet too. This is awesome. Even better than this, probably. There's no crit rate on this. 78. Let's see if this platinum stuff is worth it. 79. Nope. Officially not worth it. Alright. Alright, so I'm happy with that. And I'm confident that I will be able to die. So, like, you can make a strong one. You just don't want to go crazy and have one that's going to out-survive your muzaka. Now, this is how I've geared my muzaka. I think this is the best possible build we could have. I am skeptical about using the Black Ranger set. Though it would be much easier to get than a Pathfinder. So, just is what it is. Also, if you already have 3 immunities on your muzaka, that kind of stinks. Because you could really get quite a good chunk of stats with your potentials here. I have very high crit rate. I would be happy if it was 10% less and I had another maybe 1200 to 1500 defense. Like, I'd be happy with that. I'm thinking about switching a couple potentials. But at the same time, I really don't think I need it. Now, for these two sets, I'm two-piecing them. I don't care about the 7% attack. And I could get crit damage on this too, but it's fine. I don't want to reroll this all pink thing. It's good for my counter set. But I'm not going for the 12% attack. I'm just going for the 7% recovery because I think that I need the defense more. And this is basically the best chest piece for 2-star in the entire game. Unless somebody has the exact same thing and this is pink. Well, for this map, arguably, if it was instead of that pink defense, it was the 1% recovery, but still, that's great. And also the two piece on this. So because we're trying to kill the sixth boss now, I could probably work on these potentials, but HP, damage taken, defense, and HP recovery, it's not worth rerolling it. So this is what I'm stuck with. It's assets plus 13. It's the only reason I'm using it, for the HP and defense on the base stats and it being plus 13. If there's an SS piece one, if I get a beast rain piece, like this one, plus 13 sometime, which would be unlikely. I'd rather have another weapon. If I did get a plus 13 beast rain chest piece, I'd probably put that up there. But I just don't think I have it. Oh, this one right here. This one would be the one I transcend. Come on, give me the hammers. This is what I'd put up, because this is OP. Okay, so I do have basically a perfect one. Time to get rid of all my beast rain pieces, just for this one strategy. I could transcend it with this thing. Anyway, I actually do need this so I could have 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 on 5 guys, because I have 9 beast rain pieces, and that made 10, so I can 2-piece a whole team of 5 now. Oh, wrong hero. Muzaka, there we go. I did this just for the stats on these two. Obviously the 1000, and you have to absolutely, there's no question, this is the most important set in the strategy. If you do not have the 25% decrease from Slime King, you're in quite a lot of trouble. Now, obviously, cannon pieces, the Desperado set, well, you know what, that's arguably not cannon, but we'll get to that in a bit. We'll just call it cannon for right now. Desperado set, Geese, Slime King, Gold Tiger, I think that those are basically undeniably the most useful or the best output pieces. Like, you need to have the Gold Tiger, you need to have the Slime King, or the strategy doesn't work at all. These you only need 2 pieces, and I would suggest, seeing as how neither of them have a chest piece, to get a plus 13 transcended chest piece as best you can. Plus 12 platinum would probably be fine too, depending on the potentials you have on your gear. My Pathfinder is probably a hell of a lot better than yours, because it's got potentials like this on it. So yeah. Well, actually, this isn't my best one. Should put this one on that one. But that's fine. What's the bow at? Low on crit rate, high on everything else. That's good. But your HP regen to your defense ratio. So, like, there's kind of a gold zone to hit, and I've been trying to reach that, and I'm a few pieces off. I think if I got these boots to plus 13, I think if I got even the Gold Tiger to plus 13, like, if I plus 13 all my defensive things, I know that I would kill the level 6 boss every single time. Yeah, 100% undeniably, I would kill it every single time. Maybe when Gold Tiger goes on sale, I'll go nuts or whatever, but I likely will not do that. But still, if I had that, I think that I would have literally the perfect gear build. Now, I'm going to touch on my potentials a little bit, because they're kind of really damn important, because I've generally killed the level 5 boss around turn 28 to 30, and we'll do a run at the end just so you can see everything. So HP, attack by HP, damage to boss, some extra MP, just because I was really only interested in these ones. I would much rather prefer that be hit rate, but same time, don't care. Still have good potentials and everything else. And a lot of this stuff I made before I was going for the HP regen. I thought flat defense was better than regen. I didn't foresee the skilled raid boss coming. So a lot of my stuff I have the flat defense instead of the HP regen. I kind of want to go back in time for it. Basically everything has damage to boss on it, to the best of my ability. Could I get... No, I can't. I'm trying to think if there's anything better I can have on this necklace, other than the same one's only better. And this has recovery on it also. So not only, like, the max recovery through potentials on your gear is 10%. On the 5-star gear, the accessory... Oh, I rerolled this and got damage taken, and I got a higher HP recovery now. So I decided to reroll it. I had, I think, just exactly 2 before, So now I got 2.2, and now I have the damage taken. So I'm really hopeful that I'll be able to kill the level 6 boss today. Attack by HP, recovery HP return, defense. That attack is kind of low, but whatever. But the accessory for 5-star actually has 3 random options, not 2 like all the other accessory levels. You can get attack, you can get defense, and you can get recover HP every turn only on a 5-star accessory. So you can get 2.5 here, 2.5 here for 5, and then 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2. So it's 5 and 5 is 10. So perfect potentials would be 10% regen, and this is where it gets really good for us with this build. So I got the 7% with this. If I can get up to perfect potentials later, I'll have 10% regen with gear. And then I have Muzaka's, obviously, his Ruthless skill, which gives him, 12%? I think, yeah, 12.2%. Per enemy, of course, but still, it's generally just going to be the boss after turn 24 or whatever, turn 26, forget. So the 12 and another 10 is 22, and then the EC is 7 for 29%, so close to 30% regen every single turn. With the amount that you're reducing your damage, especially if you can get your defense to really high, like I think if I had all the stuff maxed out, I would be able to get my defense, like just my gold tiger accessory and chest piece, if I maxed that out, I think I'd be up into the 18,000 defense range. Also, if I just switched one of these crit rates with the defense, which I think I might try to do before. What's my crit rate again? 68. You know what, we're gonna try and roll one right now. Let's get rid of this. No, I like to do singles normally, but I'm kind of in a hurry. Wow. Please don't waste all my things on stream. God damn it. I guess 10 times is a waste. Just give me a bunch of these. Sorry about this. Oh crap, that was defense. Well, I can't take a 390 and drop it down to a gray one, though. That's just bad. All right, I am not having good luck. 340 defense. All right, that's gonna have to do. All right, let's go over. So I dropped it to 63, but now I'm up to 6. Wow, that gave me like 700 defense for that. 69%. You know what? I'm gonna reroll this one also. I'll just keep the one. You know, I'll keep it this way. I'm trying to find a sweet spot in terms of how much defense to regen to HP you need. Now, with the regen, it regens based off your total HP. So I really like the Pathfinder. Also, the Pathfinder has a bow and a ring, so it gives you a 4-star also. So it gives you a crap ton of crit rate. If I had this transcended to plus 13 all the way to, it would be, my crit rate would probably be close to, probably close to 80%. I could also get this transcended up later too. Crit rate, attack damage, crit damage on there. I still got some micro refinements to make myself, but generally this is kind of what you want. Okay-ish amount of hit rate is going to come any day of the week. Mana doesn't matter because his skills are really cheap anyway, so you're really not using that much. Like every other turn he only loses 10 from the 50 plus his actual regen, so every second turn he's gaining mana. Attack is good enough. Like I think if I transcended everything, I'd probably be able to get up to like 38,000 ish attack to 40,000 attack, so that'd be cool. So there's lots of potential for in room here, but you're gonna want to have at least 20% regen in my opinion. I think that's what you need. If you go super, I think Powell has a 22,000 defense Muzaka, but I think his crit rate's only 27%. Now if you can't do enough damage to kill level 6 boss, you're kind of overcommitting. So I think he should probably drop something. Maybe he could just change all his potentials to crit rate and he'd be fine. I don't know. I have to go over and examine his things. But you want as much regen as you can, good amount of attack, as much defense as you can squeeze without cutting into your set selection, because these are the best ones. Like the extra HP you get from Pathfinder, especially combined with the Gold Tiger, because I do believe that in battle, it does take this HP into account into the increase you get from to the Gold Tiger. Because I'm at 132,000 HP, I believe. With the Gold Tiger effect, I'm like 260, so it does basically double. But yeah, like the more HP, the better, because all your HP is based off of that. And it really comes down to the boss has to be able to do 30% of your health in a turn. Once everything, if you get everything perfect, I don't know what my region is. Let's see, 2.2 and 2.2 is 4.4. 6.4. 7.4. There's nothing on that one. Nothing on that one. Alright, so I got 7.4 plus another 7 is 14% plus my 12.2. So it's 26.6% I heal every turn. So I have 260-ish thousand health. He has to be able to do every single turn. What's 20? What did I say? 26 something percent? Let's go down to 25, make it easier. I'm at 260,000 health. So that's 65,000 damage. He has to do 65,000 damage a turn just to do 15,000. More than 65,000 damage a turn. Anything over 65 is what gets actually dealt to my Muzaka. So that's like before I had lower defense. So now I got 1, 2, 3, and 2 for the crit rate and the defense. So we're going to go with that and see how we do. Also for Lord Masteries, very obviously you want the defense mastery and the HP mastery first and foremost. Rock power. I'm going crit rate instead of co-op mastery this week just to keep my crit rate higher for switching out some of my defense instead of the co-op overkill. Because I'm going to be aiming to kill the level 6 boss. And the rest of the points are dumped into attack just because. Alright, so sorry about the ramble on. And this is the team. And we are going to go with another Yekaterina, I guess. That doesn't exist. Oh, Studmaster. Good old Stud. And how many do we have? Quoven, Pal, me, Lord. Oh, we've only got four mercs. We need one more person to be able to step up. It's probably going to have to be Dimitri with this counter gear. I don't know if we can, if I can get on Jay's account, maybe I can tweak his stuff a little bit. Flatna should be able to build one. He's got lots of good stuff, or maybe even Velas could build one. I'll have to look at everybody and see. Alright, I forgot what I was doing. Alright, so the Studmaster. I hope I finished gearing Katrina and Dominique. I completely forget. Okay, you go here. You go here to take that sigil. You go here to go smash face that guy. You go here to pull that guy to this tile. You just go right here so you can walk over and punch him afterwards. And you can go here for the side attack. There we go. Alright, and here we go. It is not important to have arrows at the first turn if you set things up properly, but it doesn't hurt because there's no reason not to do it. Good, still able to get 1,000,000 points for overkill, so that's cool. We're gonna get most of our kills from everything. Oh, also, I have to reiterate the balance. Where is it? Defense for all allies. I hope that's a typo and it's really 1,000. For two balanced characters, 0, because he's the hero here, counts for him being here. And as a balanced type, he counts again. So it counts him twice for some reason and unlocks the balance for having only one balanced character. Just want to check Muzaka's defense real quick. Yeah, so 73%. That's good. I think we're good. Later on in the stages of the fight, instead of using the absolute protection, you're going to want to stick with combat support so you can cure the defense debuff that the boss puts on you later on. It's also important in the early stages right now to it's also in the early stages right now to make sure that he doesn't disarm your team. What? Oh, he was disarmed, so he didn't blow up. I'm fine with that, I guess. Don't ever get greedy and use your Lord skill. Man, that disarm is OP today. I wonder if other guilds are using Super Muzaka or trying to do some kind of disarm shenanigans. Because I'm getting back-to-back disarms here. I hope I don't kill the boss here, because I kind of need him to explode and kill everybody. It would be great if I actually just lost because of that. Don't blow up and kill everybody. Katrina is left alive. Disarm. Oh, I can't believe that worked. You just say it out loud. This might be actually turn out to be a really great run. There's zero chance that Katrina is gonna have any good survival here. Now at this stage in the game, if you want to switch to guild shelling, you can. I'm still not going to, just because I'm a bit of a worrywart. I don't want to have my Muzaka get disarmed for 3 turns or whatever the outrageous time he can disarm for is. But I'm really not minding Katrina staying alive and getting pot shots off when the boss isn't strong enough to take on my non-gold tiger Muzaka. It's pretty fun. Alright, there she goes. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to use the combat support right now just to clear the defense debuff. And from here on, you can basically use the combat support every 4 to 5 turns, I think. Let's see, 3, 6, 9, 12. Alright, so yeah, you got 5 turns between you're doing, and you have to defend the 5th turn also. You do not want a high counter rate for that reason specifically. You don't want to have to be dealing with killing the minions in the early stages if you have a weaker Muzaka. Hut hut hut. That one minion over there is never gonna go away. Alright, so we're on level we're on turn 14 and we're probably about to kill. Yeah, so we're on boss 5. So it's only turn 14 and we're on boss 5. So I think I kill it around turn 25 to 30-ish. I don't think I actually have to pay attention to what I'm doing now, but as long as there's minions around, it's good. That one minion I can't kill, but what he does is he makes the other one that spawns in that same location keep coming by. I'm getting an obscene amount of counterattacks today. Alright, decreased defense. Let's go with a cure on that one. Get rid of that defense debuff. Just because it bugs me to see it. Definitely didn't need it, so long as minions are spawning, you're 100% safe. pew. Oh, wow. So I guess this muzaka is really good. I think I should max out my soul gear for muzaka. If I maxed out his soul gear, I don't want the extra range on his third, because it kills minions that are out of range that I could use to heal after. I believe it does anyway. I forget, it's been so long since I had to use Blue's account, but when I used the Lord's, it was sometimes it was annoying that I couldn't get extra heals. But all of our muzakas are getting so much stronger now, I don't know if it even really needs it. Alright, so we're around turn 25, and it looks like we're pretty close to killing boss level 5. We'll have 20 turns to take on boss 6 and hope that we can stay alive. His sniper shot, if you have the defense debuff on you and your defense is too low, it does like 160k as a crit or something, or you did it to me last, this attack right there, that's what it did last week, about 160k. So if I get too low and he hits me at the right time with it and I'm under defense debuff, it'll be a little bit problematic. All the minions are gone. Yeah, level 5 can't touch us, so. But the explosion happens. That stinks too. Hopefully uses the defense. Yeah, perfect. Good timing, because now I can heal also from the suicide damage at the same time. So that was basically ideal timing. Oh, I was using it again? Okay, good. So he can't hurt me with that skill if I'm on... Oh, there's my defense. Alright, so I just want to check what my defense is right now. 61 from center, that's a 10% drop. But I think last week I was at 53%, so we'll see. Hopefully he doesn't get a crit with a snipe. And while he's switching between the skills, if he doesn't, like, he has three skills that he uses, I believe. And I think he uses them in random order. I don't know if it's there in some kind of particular order. So if that's a crit and I'm low HP at the time, it's bad. I want him to use his defense debuff skill again before I cure it. There we go. Again, ideal timing. So now he'll use the skill that disarms, but there's not enough targets, so it's fine. And I heal back basically to almost full. Defense is down. I'm up. Oh, he should be able to survive a snipe, which is what he'll probably do this turn. Oh, nope. He's in that skill again. So that's good, because I always get basically a free turn every time he does that. If only Muzaka's second skill was strong. Let's see what happens. Okay, good. No crit. We survive again for another 3 or 4 rounds of attacks. If I use the defense debuff skill here, I'll cure it again. Oh, he didn't use it. Oh, damn. That was... I'm gonna have to. It's too risky. Like, he definitely attacked out of order there, so... Please don't use it now. Yeah, he skipped the defense one. Oh, and he got a crit, too. If we didn't heal, we would have been boned. How did Stud get 12 mil and I'm only getting 9? I guess I gotta go back to Dominique and boost her up to 40,000 attack. Take some of the lead gear off. Another crit, and two crits in a row, and we're not under defense debuff. This is pretty lucky. We got combat support coming up next turn too, so I just have to have him not snipe me next turn. Oh, he didn't use defense again. So he's not even using it. Maybe I can use, if he doesn't use it this turn, I'm gonna use the absolute protection. Yeah, totally. Taking the defense debuff. Sorry, the defense buff. Because that'll get me back up that little bit of green. I should be able to protect myself from some extra damage and be able to cure myself up higher. Looks like he's only switching between those two skills now for some reason. Man, turn 46. I hope I'm able to get the kill. I guess I should have been using the 16, like that 16,000 damage. How much health does he have? 240. You know what? We could probably do the 240 and 48 for not three turns. You know, I'm gonna use Guild Shilling. Yeah, we're using the Guild Shilling. You know what? He's dead. I won't use it. But I guess I will use it, just because. Or no, I should keep it. I should keep it. I'm just gonna keep the arrows, get rid of it. 12 million. Alright, there we go. Alright, so basically, I think I've got semi-perfectly. I do think that my crit rate needs to go up a tiny bit, but where can I pinch some damage? I don't know if it's better for me to have Muzaka attacking longer. Maybe I should switch to a team that just dies really easy and let Muzaka go at it himself. We'll try that, just to get it right out. Ask somebody to put up some AoE mercs. Okay, let's get you. Ah, the hell with it. She's good enough. Well, that's not worth switching to. Do I have a plat necklace here? That's not bad. How much do I lose taking this off? All right, I'm putting this on. Back up to, oh, perfect, good. So that gave me like 1,000 attack or something like that. I think it did. I think it was 36,000 before. Now we're 37,500. If I do drop this, I just get a higher attack one. 13.3% crit rate. No, I'd fall under 100%. Whatever, I'm gonna be content with this. As always, I am not sorry for the long video. I will end it, and I'll put up another run with weaker pieces and just super strong Muzaka going all the way. I don't know what I'm doing. Alfred's way the hell over here. I'm like, yeah, where was the guy with the beard? Single AoE merc, probably one that would die. Kaznas is really OP. I could put another one and take Platinum Zero. I wonder if it's ungeared. But I want Zero to go first. Better leave guild just in case. Obviously I was lying about that whole doing a separate video. I will be kind enough to put breaks in the video though, so everybody knows where everything's at. And I guess you could just go. It doesn't matter. I'm using arrows turn one anyway. Just want everybody to blow up. Ticks. How many attacks is it? Well, I guess I can divide. So 900,000 again. Oh shoot, Muzaka is immobilized. Well, so far this has been not a good start. There we go. Okay, I think I will use the guild shelling just for the extra little bits of damage until around turn 24, just to see if it makes much of a difference. Are we on boss 5? No, boss 4. I like the pew pew sound that makes, it's cool. Think about using arrows to kill this one little minion. By the way, it'll just be replaced by one of the stronger ones. And the stronger ones, like the last two waves, usually hit a few thousand. So you might get yourself in a sticky situation, get yourself killed. Okay, we on boss? Boss 5, alright, so I guess I should just, this will be the last guild shilling. Sorry, I already forgot what I was looking at. Thank you. think I'm behind last time. Forget. I do believe I killed the boss before turn 30 on my other run. Hopefully I can still kill it. I guess it was better with the Ekaterinas. I don't know if it's just because I was getting screwed over being stuck outside the water or what. We'll see. Hope he uses the defense to decrease. He hasn't changed his attack pattern like he did last time. Yeah, there's no way we're gonna kill it. Maybe if you're already under the defense thing, he'll use that little snipe skill. So if I wait until he uses that, he'll still move on to the snipe skill next turn. So I can avoid my defense getting shot down. I think that's what it is. Just skips its priority. So he should probably use it either. Yeah, I think he'll use it this turn. Nope, he's switching back. Oh, I don't know. I'm not getting it. Alright, so not good enough. Only 9 something million. I wonder if there's a way we can make our muzaka stronger. Back to our Ekaterina, and we'll take a Ekaterina mercenary. They all seem to have disappeared. Oh, yeah, that's right. I guess I should end the video now.